angle ABC, and we are told that angle B is the 90 degree angle. So there we go. Okay, so now we have to go and label these sides accordingly. It says the cosine of A is 4/5. Okay, so let's go to A. Cosine, whoops, that should be a C. Okay, the cosine would be adjacent and hypotenuse. So that means this side must be 4 and this side must be 5. Okay, so let's label these sides. Now let's look at the second ratio, the sine of A. The sine of A is 3/5. Well, the sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse. So that means this side over here must be 3 because it's the opposite. And this side must be 5 because, well, it's 5. It was given in the other ratio. Now we're going to go through and find the cosine of C, the sine of C, and the tangent of C. So now we're going to change our perspective and look from angle C. Okay, so what is the cosine C? Well, cosine is the adjacent over hypotenuse. Now, from angle C, we're no longer have these opposites and adjacents aren't correct anymore, are they? We've changed our perspective. So now the adjacent is this side, which is 3, and at the side that's 4 is now the opposite from C. So the cosine of C is adjacent over hypotenuse, or 3/5. Okay, now let's go back for a second. What was the sine of A? The sine of A was 3/5, but the cosine of C is also 3/5. It's because they're on opposite, they're the opposite or the complementary angles, okay? So let's look at the sine of C. Okay, from angle C, we're gonna go opposite hypotenuse. So opposite is 4, hypotenuse is 5. Now notice, the sine of C is the same as the cosine of A, right? 4/5 and 4/5. Now let's look at the tangent of C. Okay, the tangent of C would be opposite over adjacent, so 4/3. Now, what would be the tangent of A? Okay, from angle A, we would do the opposite over the adjacent. So now I'm changing my perspective, right? From angle A, 3 is the opposite and 4 is the adjacent. So the tangent of A would be 3/4. What do you notice about these two ratios? They are reciprocals of each other, or they are multiplicative inverses, and that's why we can use that negative first degree power, okay? So those are just kind of some relationships within the triangle. So the cosine of C is actually equal to the sine of A, and the sine of C is equal to the cosine of A, and the tangent of C is equal to the inverse, if I flip this, the inverse of the tangent of A. So the tangents are just reciprocals of one another, okay? So that's those relationships. Now let's look at a couple little practice problems on that.